But the scholars they mention, I saw this in the Kitab Ihya Ulumuddin by Abu Hamid al-Ghazali.
Mm.
Abu Hamid al-Ghazali said, don't marry five types of women. Five types of women, don't marry them. And the opposite is true. The worst one is annana. A woman who is a what? Annana. The second one he said, hannana. The third one he said is haddaqa. The third he said it's... The fourth one he said barraqa. And the fifth one he said shaddaqa. Stay away from a woman who has those five. The first one is annana, is a woman who is يعني كثيرة الأنين والشكوى. She complains all the time. Every day she's complaining, she's got something to complain about. Everything you do for her, she's still complaining. But you could have done this. She doesn't believe that the thought counts, yeah? She doesn't believe that, the thought counts. So for her, it's like, no, that's not enough. You could have done more. I know you could have done more. Why are you just giving me this? Etc. So she's always complaining. Whatever he says and whatever he does for her, you've not done enough. So that's the first one. Stay away from a woman who's like that. Hannana. Hannana is a woman who's always saying, I could have done better than you, brother. Nah. She says to the husband, you held me down when I was young. Allahu Malik, I had options in front of me. You know, I could have been married to this type of man and I could have been married to that type of man. And she's always saying this to her husband. And she's always wishing for another situation. Don't be married to a woman like that, he said. The third one he said is a haddaqa. Haddaqa is a woman who's always, her eyesights are directed at other things. So she goes to her friend's house, she comes home and she says, our house is the worst house. You know, you've not put enough furnitures for us in the house. She goes, everyone's life and everyone's situation is the best and our one is the worst. So she always wants more. Her eyes is always at other things. But they've got better sofas than we do. But they've got a better, mashallah, house than we do. And etc. She's excessive in that. No, brothers, by the way, these terms can be present in a woman, but in a very moderate manner. Okay? Some of these have to be there and makes يعني, a female, right? But it's when things go out of the norms. Okay? It's when it goes out of the norms and the hudud. The fourth one is al-barraqa. Mm-hmm. Al-barraqa is a woman who's preoccupied with her looks. She doesn't care about the children. She doesn't care about even the house and cleanliness of the house. And she does not care in any way, shape or form about her husband. All day she's on that makeup, smacking it against her face. She's يعني, dressing up for herself. And at night time she's just taking off her makeup. She's barraqa. All she wants is glamour and glitter for herself. She's calling her friends. She's meeting up with her friends. يعني, her image, her personal image and the way she looks is the most important thing for her than more than her children and her husband and her marriage and her family. And last but not least is ash-shaddaqa. Ash-shaddaqa is a woman who doesn't stop talking. She's always talking. The man says, can I say something? She's carrying on talking. He said, have you finished? No, I've just started. And she's going on and he's always in a struggle to just get a word or two in. And those things you can tell from the beginning. Before you get married, if you're getting essays, 7 pages essays, okay, through the email, or if you're in a WhatsApp group with her brother and she's sending, so she's got a lot to say, choose a wife who يعني, speaks less, okay, and doesn't talk much. Okay, and by the way, some people might like this quality. Some brothers might be like, I was looking for this. Whatever rocks your boat, brother. If you like it, alhamdulillah. If it brings you sakina, I mean, ayati an khalaqa lakum min anfusikum azwajan litaskunu ilayha. If this brings you sakina, that was an objective, alhamdulillah. Okay, I just don't want people to hear this stuff and go home and then say to their spouses and their partner, subhanallah, the sheikh told me I should leave you. I didn't say that. I'm just mentioning these traits. If that's there and it keeps your marriage going, then it's good. Don't. And this is something we need to understand, brothers. All marriages are not the same. All marriages are not the same. And to think that the way that your marriage works is the way that somebody else's marriage is going to work, where somebody else's marriage is going to work, is a wrong and flawed argument.